Another time's gotta have someone.
Hi lovelies, it's me, Simply Sherry, making home and entertaining simple. Declutter with me. Today I am decluttering and organizing the pots and pans cabinet. A few months ago, I changed out the liners in all of my kitchen cabinets and drawers, and then I realized about a week ago that I missed this cabinet, so I have to change out the liner and see what I can get rid of or at least organize better in this area of my kitchen.
Okay, this is what it looks like inside right now. I got these sliding drawers a while back, and they're really easy to install. And then I just recently got these pot lid holders. I wanted it on the back of the inside cabinet, but when you close it, it hits these pans. So I went ahead and put it in there. I have my crock pot I've had forever, and then some bowls. I do see some stuff here that I know I haven't used in the last 6 months, so I'm probably gonna get rid of that. So I just put a white sheet here. I'm just gonna take everything out. It's much easier to just pull the blanket as opposed to moving each bowl or each pot and pan individually. So I'm going to go ahead and take out the shelf liner that's here already. This is the liner that I have in all of the drawers and cabinets in my kitchen. I got it from Target, and for this upper shelf here, I went ahead and had it overlap the edge of the shelf. I think it looks nicer, plus I didn't have to worry about cutting it perfectly. On this sliding drawer, I put this baking rack onto it so it can hold the smaller pans, and then I've just attached it with this zip tie right there. This is what the cabinet looks like now with the liners and the sliding drawers back in. All right, so I'm going to keep the crock pot. As far as the bowls, keep this. I have this one colander. I'm going to let go of this bowl because they're about the same size. This one has this jagged edge, and I'm surprised I haven't cut myself yet from there. So I'm getting rid of that. Keep them. I'm going to keep these plastic bowls because I do love them for prepping and just serving dinner, like salads or things like that for my family. They're very casual, kind of worn out, but they're still working. And then I just have this bigger bowl that I need sometimes, so I'm going to keep that. I am keeping this. This was from the thrift shop. It's an emerald. Keeping this. This is for grilling vegetables on the grill. So we still do like this one. I'm going to keep that. And then this one, because it's that green pan. And honestly, I don't know. In the beginning, I liked how it cooked. I have a few of them, frying pans. But now I don't like it, especially when I've tried to clean it to get in between here. I've had to scrub it, and it's just scraped off the material. So I think I'm gonna let this go. These two are very old, but I think I'm gonna keep the other two because sometimes when I'm cooking breakfast, one is for pancakes and one is for other stuff for breakfast. They're like trivets, and they're really, really heavy. So I'm gonna keep these. I do use them for parties. Here's another Orgreenic pan. It's specifically for pancakes. It hasn't been used a lot, so I'm gonna keep it for now. Here's a Pampered Chef pan. I'm gonna keep this. My husband, I think this is his favorite pan. I particularly don't like it. And then here's an Orgreenic one. See, you can see it's hard to clean. So have you guys had trouble with this type of pan? Let me know. And I'm gonna let this go. I have two strainers. So this one we use all the time. This one I don't think I've used. I believe this was a hand-me-down. So I'm going to let this go. All right, so here are a few of the lids. I have two more. So this one I'm keeping because I still have that pot. I'm gonna keep this one. This I have the little pot for that, and this one I have too. This one I am letting go because I actually destroyed the little pot that this went with. So that is going. I'm keeping these two lids because those are complete with the pots and pans for that. I'm keeping this frying pan. The brand is Calphalon. Is that how you pronounce it? And then the smaller frying pan I'm keeping too. And then I am keeping this one. I use it a lot to warm up soups and to fry things in smaller batches. And I use this a lot also, so I'm keeping this one. All right, so I found five things that I am no longer using that I am getting rid of. And the important thing now is the ones that I am going to put back to make it a more functional system. I have been stacking all the pots and the pans together, and it's just been a little bit cumbersome sometimes to take them all out, unstack them, and then stack them back on. The lids will go back on here. It is functional for me, it is working. I have the lids from the largest to the smallest because of the roof up here. The larger lid won't be able to get inside. And this last lid I'll put here. And then for this that I attached here, I'm gonna go ahead and put the smaller frying pans there. Then I'm gonna put the two pots nestled into each other here in the sliding drawer. I'm gonna put the trivets here towards the back left. Then I'm going to put a command hook on the inside of this cabinet for the strainer. So I just put the strainer onto the command hook already so I know kind of where to put the command hook. All right, friends, all done. The shelf liner is in. The items that I don't use have been decluttered, and the items that I do use have now been reorganized in this small space. I hope you enjoyed this video of decluttering my pots and pans cabinet. Please let me know in the comments below what area of your kitchen you are decluttering. And if you're new to my channel, please hit that subscribe button. I'd love to have you on this journey with me to making home and entertaining simple. See you in the next one. Bye.